Peter Cook was God's gift to a talk show host. He had an opinion about most things, if only because, as Peter Ustinov once observed, the joy of being interviewed was that you often found out for the very first time what you thought about something. This is an interview we did in 1976. The other guest is one of Peter's great heroes, Danny Blanchflower, captain of Spurs and Northern Ireland.
My final guest tonight is, I hope, carrying a £5 note in his hand. It's what he owes me for assuming I couldn't last a programme without mentioning my hometown. I'll give him a fiver for any charity he cares to mention if he survives the next half hour also without mentioning Tottenham Hotspur. That's his team, which accounts for his highly developed sense of humour. Ladies and gentlemen, actor, writer, humorist, columnist, and one of a dying breed of Englishmen, the Spurs supporter, Mr. Peter Cook.
Actually, Michael, I do owe you a fiver for last week. If you examine what I wrote in the column, it said any programme that omitted the word Barnsley. Mm-hmm. In fact, it's been mentioned three times so far, so I don't owe you for this week.
Not by me.
No, I didn't say by you, I just said omitted the word Barnsley. Read it very carefully, the small print. You should always do that. But here's a fiver to whichever charity you like.
Thank you very much indeed, sir.
And by the way, I have something to reveal of an interesting nature. Because I got a lot of letters from readers of the Daily Mail pointing out that you weren't born in Barnsley. You were born in Cudthorpe. Or Cudthorpe, as we know it.
There is no such place in the world called Cudthorpe. Where I was
it's
born...
It's close to Barnsley.
That's right. And his name is Cudworth.
Cudworth.
Except...
Well, a lot of people there have forgotten what it's called.
Except it's pronounced Cudworth.
Cudworth.
Aye.
Aye, well, if you're born in Cudworth, I've got nought against thee.
That's right.
Well, that'll make me laugh. You won't make me laugh, I know what you northern buggers are like. You won't make me laugh.
Well, you don't think we're very funny?
Oh, I think you're hilarious, but you, that's the attitude, you see. You won't make me laugh. Smart southern bastard, you won't make me laugh. No, I've come here, paid £5 a wife and I, to see some entertainment, see some funny man make us laugh. We won't laugh. Not a chance, we won't laugh. We'll be better. No, I've come here, paid £5 a wife and I, to see some entertainment, see some funny man make us laugh. We won't laugh. Not a chance, we won't laugh. We'll be better. No, we won't laugh. I don't play up north much, you know.
I was going to say, you've not done the clubs, have you?
I've not been asked, no.
But if they did ask you, do you think you might take it up?
And no, I wouldn't do it anymore. I was once offered a ludicrous thing, which was a stand-up role in Las Vegas. That was in 1965. $10,000 a week, which is a lot of money. And I said, but I haven't got an act. I said, never mind, Peter, nobody cares about that. It's just a small room, Peter. I said, well, maybe a small room. I'm still making an ass of myself, aren't I? I said, oh, another thing, Peter, nobody will hear you. They'll all be talking amongst themselves and waiting to get back to the gambling. So there's really no worry for you there. You just pick up the money and talk for half an hour. I couldn't face it. I didn't have the nerve.
No.
I would now, if you're listening, Lou.
What about this, going back to this sport thing? In fact, you did want to be a professional footballer, didn't you?
No, I didn't want to be a professional footballer.
Oh, I see. All right. Can I rephrase it? Coming back to this sport thing, you'd never wanted to be a professional footballer, did you?
That's almost exactly right. You've got exactly good notes there, yes. No, I didn't, because I was no good at it.
You weren't?
I knew I'd never be a professional footballer. And, no, I enjoyed watching it, that's all.
Are there any sports you don't like?
Yeah, rugby league, I can't stand it. It's the most boring game. I like practically every sport in the world. I like darts, anything. But rugby league, it ruins my Saturday afternoon. Despite Eddie Waring, who I worship and admire. It just does seem to me a remarkably stupid game. And the people who play it, not all of them, some are very fit and agile and beautiful to behold, but they do look like a muddy lot of half drunk idiots. They're overweight.
I'll have you know you're looking at the president of Keithley Rugby League Football Club. Me.
Well, you're looking well. I can't see
that's
why
right. I'm very, very insulting. I think it's one of the greatest of games, actually. It's a better game than rugby union, that's for sure.
Well, I wouldn't. Rugby union is horrible because I played it.
You did?
I hated playing it, yes.
You'd be forced to play it because of the public school you went to,
yes,
I suppose.
Yes, I was forced to play rugby union. And, they picked us, you know, all there not wanting. Well, someone wanted to play, and I wasn't. And I thought, you know, there were 16 of us, I might be left out. but for some reason I was placed at full back, and I spent my whole time avoiding the ball. My tactic, I looked terribly knowing, as if I was anticipating an attack coming from the left. Therefore, I ran to the left when in my heart I knew that the attack was coming to the right. But often, you know, they'd forget what to do and actually come at me. And in my rush to get away from the ball once, I fell on it. I was then hacked to bits, you know, by forwards' feet and got the reputation for courage. That cook looks awfully promising. Did you see the way he fell on the ball?
Did you enjoy it or did you not? I mean, what do you remember of public school?
Trying to avoid buggery.
Really?
Yeah.
It was a particular time of year.
Bugger time? No. No, I've always wanted to look up an old acquaintance of mine. I won't mention his name. He'll know perfectly well who it is. Dirty sod. And I was a young, you know, quite pretty boy. I was number three in the charts at the school. And he was a prefect, and he came into my cubicle while I was reading a motor magazine. I can't think why, because I'm not interested in cars. It must have been the only thing to read. And he sat on the bed, and he put his hand up the back of my pyjamas, started stroking my back. And he said, do you mind that, cook? And I said, yes. Or rather, yes. And he went away. In fact, I didn't mind it at all. It was a very pleasurable sort of feeling, but I felt I ought to say yes, because my master had had me in at the beginning of the term and said, as a young boy, cook, you'll discover a lot of other boys at this school. There are young boys and the older boys. Sometimes the older boys do things. He paused a long time. I thought, that's fairly transparent, they do things. Two younger boys. And I didn't know what he meant. tell me. So, I thought, buggery, and that is probably not to be taken willingly. But that's where I got my sense of injustice about the whole world, was Ted Dexter.
Why?
Ted Dexter, later captain of England.
Yes.
Well, I was always envious of him, because he used to drive up, I think, in an Alfa Romeo. He was head boy, good at every sport, and so on. And he beat me for drinking cider at Henley Regatta. Now, okay, you weren't allowed to drink cider at Henley Regatta, so perhaps I deserve to be beaten. What I thought was a little unfair was that I'd seen him coming out of the pub with a bottle of scotch.
I see. Sneaky type, huh?
Well, no, just very big and strong.
And this burning sense of injustice led...
It wasn't burning. Just for about 6 hours.
That wasn't then at the back of your mind, then, that sort of whatever thing it created in you, when you, in fact, became a founder member of Private Eye. I mean, why did you...
Before they all scream at me on Private Eye, I was not a founder member of Private Eye. Private Eye started without me. And I was planning a similar sort of magazine at the same time. And I was delighted when they got into debt and I came in with some money.
You're still the...